In other news, the Senate is holding a general inquiry into the expanded enhanced defense cooperation agreement between the Philippines and the U.S. Senator Aimee Marcos questions the locations of the EDCA sites, with two in Cagayan, saying they seem to be random and no longer aligned with the purpose of modernization. But Defense Senior Undersecretary Carlito Galvez Jr. insists the sites are strategic and were picked to address vulnerabilities in several locations.
The instruction of the President is for us to prepare for external defense. And with that, we are trying to really allocate some resources and our modernization program on the northern side. If you look at the configuration of the armed forces strategy, our vulnerabilities is in the north.
I come from the north, sir. I don't feel very vulnerable. Our fishermen in Cagayan and the Ilocos Seas are not being harassed by anyone.
Madam, if you look at the defense strategy that we will be having, if we are interested on maritime security, our northern part is very, very weak.
Senator Marcos also slams the lack of formal documents on the establishment of the four new EDCA sites across the Philippines.
Madam, hindi ba nakakatakot na nagdadagdag at nag-uumpisa tayo, nagpapaputok ng javelin at kung ano-ano pa, ngunit wala tayong kasulatan, anumang papel, anumang kasunduan at pagkakaintindihan?
We're still discussing with the United States on the substance of the notes.
I'm confused. There is an annex, but it's subject to an exchange of notes, or there is no annex, which is why you have not been able to provide the committee with a copy. Which is it, Paul?
Madam Chair, there is an annex to the EDCA, and once we have agreed on an exchange of notes, we would be adding to that annex the new locations. But we're still in the process of negotiating the substance of the notes with the U.S. Once that's agreed, we will then have an exchange of notes, and then that will be included in the annex to the EDCA.
So the annex is of no value. There is no annex, for all intents and purposes, until today.
Suspended lawmaker Arnulfo Teves Jr.'s alleged involvement in illegal gambling in focus in today's resumption of the Senate inquiry into the killing of Negros Oriental Governor Roel de Gamo. An official of the National Bureau of Investigation bared an alleged attempt by Teves to make them stop their crackdown on online cockfighting. NBI Central Visayas Director Renan Oliva says Teves reached out to him after carrying out an e-sabong raid in Cebu last year.
I was then surprised of his response to me, which he told me that he will sue my men for stealing 7 million pesos at the cockpit. He continued to say that he will spare me from the case if I make it negative of any incoming operations against Isabong. I just laughed because I told him, you cannot tell me to betray my oath as a law enforcement officer. Hindi kita isasama sa kaso ng mga tao mo pag in-negative mo ang mga order sa'yo na mag-operate ng Isabong operation.
Ako sinabihan nun, sagutin ko rin siya, how dare you? Who you? Para sabihan mo ako ng ganun. Kala ko, polis lang ang kaya niya takot-takotin doon, pati NBI pala.
Senator Ronald De La Rosa also slams what he called the prevalence of organized crime in Negros Oriental.
Mahirap para sa akin tanggapin na ang karahasang nagaganap sa probinsya ng Negros Oriental ay tila organized na. Tila may kasunduan at arrangement na ang mga masasangamang loob na nasa loob din ng mga ahensya ng national at local government kung paano gumawa ng krimen, kung paano pumatay ng hindi nahuhuli.
Earlier today, Congressman Teves again insisted the investigation into the killing of Governor De Gamo is unfair. Teves also claiming he is now being subjected to trial by publicity.
Trial by publicity. Mm-hmm. Sabay, ang daming nililihis na issue. Ito yung gusto ko maintindihan ng taong bayan. gawin natin yung simple lang, di ba? Ba't patay nagpat nagsisiraan? Bakit, di ba? Kung ano lang yung totoo. Ang mali kasi dito, inuna nila yung suspect bago yung investigasyon. Kaya ngayon, kailangan nilang ipilit na yung investigasyon tumama sa sa tinuturo nila. Hindi dapat ganun. Mag-imbestiga ka muna bago ka magturo.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. speaking out against political violence in the country. Marcos ordered the National and Regional Peace and Order Councils to root out violent actions targeting politicians. To do that, Marcos suggests increasing visibility of law enforcers in the streets. He also wants the councils to focus on addressing the proliferation of illegal or loose firearms.
There's no other method that I know about that is effective. But for us to be watchful, to conduct continuous drives every so often, mga random drive na maglalagay tayo bigla ng checkpoint at matitignan natin basta't walang mga illegal firearms. That is one of the tools that we have to watch out when we are trying to avoid what has been a developing warlordism, I think, around the country. But that's one thing that we can do. Even if the political violence stems from drugs. It stems from the territorial fights over areas where drugs are distributed.
He issued that statement during the first joint National Peace and Order Council and Regional Peace and Order Council meeting in Malacañang. Chinese State Councilor and Foreign Minister King Gang set to arrive in the Philippines this week. He will be on an official visit from April 21st until the 23rd. The visit will be a continuation of the series of high-level interactions between Manila and Beijing. The Chinese Foreign Minister is expected to exchange views on the bilateral consultation mechanism on the South China Sea with his counterpart Enrique Manalo. An outpouring of tributes for Manila's former top diplomat Albert Del Rosario after he passed away Tuesday. Del Rosario helped the Philippines win an arbitral ruling at The Hague, which dismissed Beijing's sweeping claims in the South China Sea. Katrina Domingo looks at his legacy in this report.
A businessman, a diplomat, and a patriot who did not back down against China's incursions in the West Philippine Sea.
When there's an issue involving China, it's difficult to decipher when our people speak, whether they're speaking for the Philippines or whether they're speaking for China. So, but I think we should work on ensuring that the Philippines, for the sake of our children and our grandchildren, does not become a province of China.
This is how former Foreign Affairs Secretary Albert Del Rosario is being remembered after he passed away at the age of 83. The Department of Foreign Affairs did not divulge Del Rosario's cause of death, but confirmed that the former secretary died while en route to the United States. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. condoled with Del Rosario's family and released a statement calling the late ADR an honorable diplomat who is known for his patriotism and integrity. Incumbent Foreign Affairs Secretary Enrique Manalo described his predecessor as a consummate diplomat and an inspiring leader who led the DFA with integrity and unwavering commitment to public service. Born in November 1939, Del Rosario finished his high school and college in the United States, where he earned his bachelor's degree in economics. His business experience and portfolio spans across the sectors of banking, real estate, shipping, telecommunications, pharmaceutical, and retail, among others. He served as a director of large corporations, including PLDT, Metro Pacific Investments Corporation, Philex Mining Corporation, and Manila North Tollways Corporation. Del Rosario was also the chairman of consultancy firm Stratbase Incorporated and was a supporter of charitable institutions like the Philippine Cancer Society and the Cultural Center of the Philippines Foundation. He started his diplomatic career as Philippine ambassador to the United States during the administration of former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo. During his tenure, he secured funding assistance for the Philippines amounting to $1.2 billion, as well as business opportunities and investments, particularly in the business process outsourcing industry. From 2011 to 2016, Del Rosario served as the Foreign Affairs Secretary of late President Benigno Aquino III. ADR bagged many accomplishments as DFA chief, but he is most credited for leading the Philippine delegation that challenged Beijing's sweeping claim in the South China Sea, a battle which the Philippines won in the International Arbitral Court in The Hague, the Netherlands. The arbitral ruling is now being used as the basis of several countries to invalidate and debunk China's unilateral ownership of nearly the entire South China Sea. His former colleagues in the Aquino III cabinet have nothing but praises for Del Rosario.
Even if he doesn't speak Filipino all that often, he was very, very Filipino at heart. And whenever we spoke about foreign affairs, he was the first one who would always bandy the flag.
After President Noynoy Aquino's term ended, Del Rosario returned to the private sector. But he continued to fight for the Philippines' national interest. In 2019, Del Rosario, along with former Ombudsman Conchita Carpio Morales, filed a complaint against Chinese President Xi Jinping before the International Criminal Court for Beijing's alleged crimes against humanity. Del Rosario claimed that China's activities in the South China Sea have damaged the environment and marine resources that could have been enjoyed by other countries that have a right to these waters. The case, however, was dismissed because the ICC had no jurisdiction over China. Lawmakers expressed their sadness over Del Rosario's passing. Senate Majority Leader Joel Villanueva says Del Rosario's contributions to the country are now forever etched in the country's history. House Deputy Speaker Ralph Recto praised Del Rosario for being a defender of overseas Filipino workers. It was Del Rosario who led appeals to the Indonesian government to postpone the execution of Mary Jane Veloso, a Filipina death row convict who was sentenced to death for allegedly bringing illegal drugs to Indonesia in 2010. Several top diplomats in the country also paid tribute to Del Rosario, calling him a charismatic and indefatigable diplomat who helped strengthen the relationship between the Philippines and other countries. Business groups like the Makati Business Club and the Management Association of the Philippines also lauded Del Rosario for raising the standards of economic diplomacy and for his overwhelming love of country. Katrina Domingo, ABS-CBN News.